Simpson, Why I Am Single. I could tell us what that's off of, because I like the song back in it a little bit. But yeah, I'm very far from the camera. I haven't done this for over 3 weeks. I don't know. In the last chapter of Chilling in the Summer, Back to School, Chilling in the Summertime, it's Christmas, I would say. Yeah, it's Christmas, and apparently, Justin did a special thing for Austin. He got his dad able to video call him, so that was pretty nice. And that's pretty much the only thing that happened. I don't believe they had sex. I could be wrong. But yeah. So, that's a little weird. Whatever. Alright, chapter 19. The day after Christmas, 10:10 a.m., Justin's point of view. I woke up with Austin Lena talking, oh shit, last night was the absolutely amazing. Literally no one could even make me feel as good as Austin. The way he worked his hips on me last night, and every time I moaned, it was like I was hearing angels of heaven sing as the gates opened. Let me stop thinking about it. This, I'm getting a little too excited down there. Austin is so cute when he sleeps. Now I'm starting to sound creepy. Ew, oh my god, he's drooling on my... Now that's gross. I think about it usually if I'm drooling, I'm getting some of the best sleep of my life. Austin's started in his cute little morning voice. Morning, baby, did I wake you? No, well, your bones are kind of dead. He replied, nuzzling his head in my neck. I'm sorry, Aussie. I'll take care of it. With that, I started to slide from under him, but he stopped me. I got you. Is all he said. Then he slid down. He slid down and man, did he have me. Oh, hot damn. Austin, don't be a tease. Yeah, he continued to place kisses on my manhood and lick it like a lollipop. Austin... The man had me whimpering under his heavily touch, and then he stopped. No touching, no licking, no kissing, nothing. Austin, I said sternly. Shut up, I'm working my magic, he said, with a tug of my manhood. With that, I threw my head back with a groan of pleasure escaping my lips. Austin looked at me and looked his, then went down on me. He took me and all of me. At one time, he didn't even gag. Biggest gasp to ever leave my lip. Austin. I couldn't help but run my fingers through his hair. The way he was pleasing me, and I had to grab onto something. Justin, stop screaming.
Shut up, Jack.
Some of us have major hangovers. Scooters stated as he walked out of the kitchen and ascended up the staircase towards his room. I didn't even know he came home last night, let alone how he got to the kitchen. Then, of course, halfway he came back up the stairs. Don't none on my couch, he warned. Way to kill the mood, Scooter. Austin said as he came back up and gave me a kiss. We're gonna finish this, alright? Cause I'm not anywhere near done with you. Austin says he got off me and put on his boxers and head upstairs, leaving me naked alone under the blanket we managed to put on us last night around 3. Ugh. I was so close. I got up and put my boxers on and head upstairs to my room. Fuck, it's cold in this house. Ah! Is all I had once. I had successfully climbed into bed and started to doze off. But clearly, that high-pitched screech came from Austin, and I wasn't going to let him die or whatever. But I didn't have to get up, because the next thing I knew, Austin was in my room. Baby, what happened? I asked with a lack of consideration in my tone. I was getting in the shower, and there was a huge-ass spider. Justin Justin, go do something about it. Justin, just take a shower in my bathroom. I laughed at it. Justin, please. Baby, why are you stressing about something so stupid? Just go get in my shower. No, now stop being a little prick and fucking do it. With that, I got my ass out of bed and did as my boyfriend told me. Oh shit, this is one big ass fire. I couldn't have gotten it, but that thing is the size of my thumb, and I got a big ass hand. Guess I should have told him I'm scared of spiders too. And of course, Scooter doesn't fuck with bugs either. Where's my mom when you need her? Honey, what's that? Oh, that little thing. My mom picked up the spider and simply tossed it out of Austin's bathroom window. Then closed the window and walked over and patted me on the shoulder. Hold the fuck up. When did she get here? I'm not even gonna bother right now. I just want nothing to go back to sleep. As I walked back in my room, I hear the shower going, which could have easily eluded one thing, Austin. I get in the shower right behind this dude. I guess you could say I was a little rough with him the way I had pushed him up against the tile. He seemed to like it. It was rough. It was rough with like this. I grabbed his dick and started stroking it while yanking it, but it didn't stop the moan's escape from Austin's lip. Oh, Justin, fuck me.
Wow, get good, scrub.
You like when I'm rough with you, baby. I coo in his ears. I started to leave light love bites on his neck. God, I cannot breathe today. Oh my god, right there. Bingo! There's a sweet spot, the base of his neck. I yanked my head away from the tile and kissed him roughly. And as I pulled my hand away, his arching hard to get ready to prep him, he whimpered into the kiss. Surprisingly enough, the next thing I knew, Austin was placing my tip at his entrance. Austin, no prep?
I heard you.
I asked, not wanting to hurt the man. I care about mostly in my life. Justin, fuck me, he demanded. I started to slide into him, and he shut his eyes, and I stopped at the movement as he cursed under his breath. Babe, just do it fast. And I did. I slid right into him, and he took it with a groan. I'm not small, that's for sure. And for Austin to just want me to hurt him like that, like this, makes no sense. Austin, are you okay? Yeah, I'm fine. So are you gonna keep talking, or are you just gonna fuck my brains out? With that, I started to move in and out of Austin, slowly just to make sure I wasn't hurting him. Oh, Justin, harder, faster. And I did pick up my pace a little. Austin, you're so tight. Justin, fuck me faster. God, this boy is so demanding today, but I don't care. By his request and the time, I really did pick up my pace. God, his ass was so tight and amazing. Our moans started turning into screams of pleasure as our bodies collided with each other. And I continued to fuck his perky little ass harder and faster. Yeah, baby, you're into that. Oh gosh, I'm not reading that part. Justin pounds my tight. Oh god, harder. As I pounded against the tile, I grabbed on an extremely rock-hard cock, feeling his pork gum from his tip, and started to jack him off, matching my hand pace with the pace I was slamming my dick into his tight hole. Fuck, I'm gonna come, he cried, and started to tense up against my body. Ugh! I do not like reading this shit. Whatever. He screamed and cummed in my hand, and I was getting closer and closer to my own coming. I grabbed onto his hips and held him steady as I ran in him. Damn it, Austin, I'm close. Fuck, I'm getting there. Oh, fuck, yes, Austin. I screamed as my seed filled his tiny ass. I pulled out of him and turned around and kissed me by him. And he turned around and kissed me violently and bit my lip, shrinking blood, and I pulled away, laying his back, hit the wall hard. Shit, Austin, that fucking hurt. Sorry, babe, let me make it up to you. Round two? Austin apologized as he dropped to his knees and took a semi-hard member in his hand and started stroking me. Austin, yeah, baby? He answered and looked up and started at me and taking me in the mouth. Made me groan as I put my head up against my head against the wall. Fuck, this guy is a sex god, and his tongue is pure fucking magic. Shit, he looks so hot like that. I praised him as he bowed his head on my length, slowly taking in more of my length as he went down, gradually picking up his pace. At the point, I was fucking messing, screaming Austin's name with the various curse words as I got close to my climax. And Austin pulled away from my throbbing member. Why do you fuck my mouth, baby? He cut me off, and I'd never been more eager to shove my dick down Austin's throat. I grabbed his hair tightly as I fucked his mouth and started to gag, but I kept going and fucking the living hell out of his mouth, knowing I was gonna come soon. Fuck, Austin, you look so fucking hot like this. Just let me fuck your mouth, like. You're such a little cock slut. You like that, baby. You like when I fuck your mouth with my big cock. I cooed to him, only getting closer to my climax. I don't mean to hurt him, but his next action was what surprised me. He grabbed onto my ass, putting my dick in his mouth, more if it was even possible. At this point, he had a few tears in his eyes. With a few last hip thrusts, I cummed in Austin's mouth, letting my back hit the shower wall. Austin swallowed, of course. God, was this boy a slut? My slut. You're so sexy when you choke on my dick.
Fucking Tennessee.
I kissed my soon-to-be boyfriend. You taste amazing. His voice horizons. He licked his lips and came close to my ear. So, round three in the shower, bathroom or bedroom? He asked. How about we finish doing what we were meant to be doing in the shower and then go get dressed, watch TV? Sound good? I protagonized the over-horny teenage boy. Not really, he pouted. I love you. I hate you. He sat and brought me closer, grabbing my ass and kissing me, eventually wrapping his arms around my neck. Babe, calm down. What's gotten into you? Not you, apparently, he pouted again. Is everything okay? Yes, everything is fine. Can't I just be a little slut for my boyfriend? Boyfriend, huh? Well, whatever you want to call us.
Oh,
us?
Hey,
Justin?
You're using cudas.
Justin? Austin warned? Okay. I kissed him again and got out of the shower and went into my room and threw on a pair of basketball shorts and a crop top.
Well,
crop top?
The
why the fuck do I own a crop top? Scooter probably fucked up my laundry and I just shrugged it off and went downstairs and saw my mom making pizza. Hey, mommy, I greeted him with a hug and kiss her on the cheek. Ew, you and Austin just had sex. You probably gave him head, and now you're kissing me, she shrieked. First off, Austin gave me head. Secondly, I trailed off, giving her multiple kisses on her cheek. Stop, she screamed.
You gotta get that gay pride.
And she was also laughing to me, to which I did abide by her command. Where's Scooter, I asked.
Bull.
Sleeping off his hangover. Things got a little crazy last night, I ushered. She said it was almost the most obvious thing in the world. So then the beautiful deep dish pizza you're making is for me? Huh! She laughed in my face. You don't deserve it, but you must know it's for everyone. Oh, well. Well, it's me and Austin, but it really should be Austin and I. Oh, well, Austin and I worked up an appetite, so you might want. Guess you better start making your own pizza for you and Austin, then. She cut me off with much sass in her voice. Just kidding, and so how long are you here for? Just till New Year's. I'm gonna talk to my therapist about coming home. Why, do you miss me? Ha ha, hell yeah! I mumbled the yes. There was no way in hell I was gonna let my mom know I missed her. I'm a grown-ass boy. Aw, baby, I miss you too. Now do me a favor and put some sauce and cheese and whatever else you want on this pizza while I go check on your father. Ugh, he was up this morning. I'm sure he's fine. He's still my husband. I have to check on him. So take over. Thanks, honey. She walked in her adulterous husband, but not before grabbing a bottle of water and an apple for the poor man. Hey, sexy, I said, a voice from behind me. The person wrapping their skinny little arms around my waist started to kiss my neck. Hey, Austin, you see mommy? I greeted. Yeah, for a quick second, she was on her way upstairs. You look so hot when you're cooking, Austin said as he rubbed his crotch against my ass. When am I not hot? I asked, knowing the answer to the question. Never, unless you're being a little prick who won't fuck me. He answered, obviously still trying to get in with me. You need to calm down with all the sex. You're a fucking nimble baby, I told him. What the hell, Justin? He said, unwrapping his arms and shoving me forward in the process. Well, you're acting like a little whore. I pounded the shit out of you, and you were in pain, and you told me to go faster and harder when you were practically crying.
Right now.
Then you wanted round three? Shut up, Justin, Austin stormed off. Jesus, what's his problem today? What just happened? Mom asked. Which was truthfully an excellent question. Mom, he just lashed out at me. What do I do? I mean, she's a woman. She'll know what to do. Go talk to him. Maybe he's acting now to get your attention. She answered, I immediately went to go find my boyfriend. I checked his room, which he wasn't in. Then I checked his bathroom, wasn't there. My bathroom, no. I had no idea where he could have went. I really had no idea at this point. Like, he's seriously MIA. I don't just want to give up. He might think I don't care, but in that case, I refuse to mess this up. I refuse to mess this up this time. I might have actually loved him compared to Selena and Vince. I guess I could go check with Scooter and see if he knows anything. It's open, Scooter answered after my knock, giving me the okay to head in. Hey, Scoot, Austin, I was looking for you. What are you doing in here? But quickly, cut off my Scooter. Nothing. Did you need something, Scooter asked? Yeah, my boyfriend. Austin, I'm sorry what I said. It was a joke, and I was stupid. And a stupid one at that. I will never, ever do something like that again, okay? I'm just rambling on about being sorry. And shut up, Austin interrupted my rambling, which I did stop talking. Just, it's okay. I don't care, honestly. But Scooter and I are in the middle of something, so can you leave? He said this with all an attitude, signaling me to go. Yeah, sorry. I walked out of the room, going to take a nap. Austin's point of view. Scooter's the guy's an asshole. Yeah, he apologized, right? But now he called me a slut. Is it so bad to want to pleasure a man?
Oh, yeah, he's got to control that recoil.
No, there isn't, but Justin, he never seen you act like that. What did you do? What did you want him to do? Scooter asked.
Oh!
Even though it was clearly rhetorical. Well, he didn't have a problem with Vincent. What? Austin, are you jealous? No! You know what? I had to pee. You should dress. I changed the subject and getting off the bed, hanging the door. When it comes to Vincent, you should be more than jealous. Scooter warned as I left the room. I went to Justin so we could talk. Only to find him pulling on his jacket. Hey, Jay. He didn't say anything and just gave me a head nod. Where are you headed? I proceeded to ask questions. Out. He stayed as he checked his pockets, making sure he had everything. Cool. Is there, like, a certain place you're going? No. He stayed and left the room quickly and grabbed a pair of shoes and the jacket from my room. Hold on, I have to find out where it was. And a jacket from my room and followed suit. Mom, I'll be back, Justin yelled to Vi in the kitchen as he exited the house and slammed the door in my face. I'm going with Justin, I yelled to Vi as I too left the house and I almost died getting in the car with him. He started the car as I opened the door and started to back out of the driveway. I was 1 foot in the car. Jesus Christ, Justin, as he stopped the car, get out, he demanded. Why can't I go with you? Because I need some space before I give it to you. Now, I need space. So, Austin, please get out of my car.
Okay.
Are you sure you're not going to see Vincent? No. Then why can't I go? Fine, you know what? Fuck that. He got out of the car and went back into the house. What the hell is this problem? After a few minutes of waiting, I decided to go in. And of course, Justin was sitting on the couch and looking at his phone, ignoring me. Justin? Can you just talk to me? What did I even do wrong? I asked. He didn't do anything. Alright. I already told you. Austin, I need space, alright? Fine. Can't do anything but walk away, so that's exactly what I did. So tired of this bullshit with Justin. It's either we're too perfect, or we're fighting like Lucifer and Michael. Austin, come down here, Patty's voice rang from the kitchen. Great, just what I need, a lecture. What's up, Patty? I said as I entered the kitchen, everything okay with you and Justin? I asked, I'm pretty sure she knew the answer. Honestly, Patty, I don't want to talk about it. I really don't want to have another discussion about Justin cheating on me. I said, hold on there. Justin's not cheating on you. Patty, he is. I didn't want to believe him after seeing some of the texts and talking to Scooter. It's true. Do you honestly think he would make the same mistake twice? I don't know. Can I go to my room now? Yeah, I'm not sure we'll be very soon. Not hungry. I said and went to my room and laid on my bed. I've even given up everything at this point. Love is not real. Life is an illusion. I'm just a robot. Skipping days, JB and Austin haven't talked. Justin stayed in his room the entire time. Austin has hung out with Alex and Niall. I'm skipping to New Year's because it's taking me too long to write this. I'm going to go back to my original writing style. Patty walks in Justin's room. Hey, honey, get up. Justin, no. Patty, for Christ's sakes, baby, you haven't eaten since Christmas. For all I know, you're dieting. And you probably pissed yourself in bed. Justin, Mom, I didn't piss myself. I want to go to sleep, okay? Patty, no, not okay. Get the fuck up. It's New Year's. You're going out. Justin, I don't want to. Seriously, Mom, I want to sit here and watch the ball drop in Times Square. Hey, can you at least have one of your friends come over tonight so they know you aren't dead? Justin smiles a little. Yes, Mom. Hey, good. Now get in the shower. I made breakfast, and Austin isn't here, so you don't have to worry about seeing him. Justin, thanks, Mom. I'll be down with you. Gets off his bed. Patty, Jesus. Justin, you're such a twig. Justin, I get my slender figure from you. Patty chuckles and shakes her head. Go get in the shower, Justin. Wait, Mom, can we go dye my hair today? Patty, sure, honey. Whatever you want. I'm just happy to see you up and about again. Justin, thanks, Mom. As Patty leaves, Justin goes in the bathroom and takes a shower. 30 minutes later, Justin walks into the kitchen and sees a bunch of food on the table and a note from Patty. Note, hey, sweet, enjoy. I had to run to the store after that, but we can do whatever you want. I love you, little man. Awesome. Phone rings. Hello? Hey, Justin, can we talk? Justin, I was actually about to call you. Would you want to come over for breakfast? Blank, sure be there. Sure, I'll be there in five. Justin, can't wait. Hangs up and sets the table for two people. I was going to leave it like that, but you guys have been waiting patiently, so keep ringing. 7 minutes later, Blank rings the doorbell. Justin opens the door and lets Blank in. Hey, Kaden. Kaden, hey, man. Justin, so I mean to call you, well, all the guys, really. I've just been so busy, you know, the holidays and everything. Kaden, I totally get you, man, but I wanted to talk to you about something other than business. Justin, okay. Oh, okay, what's up, man? Kaden, well, it's about you and Vinny. Justin, okay, what's on your mind? Kaden, I just wanted to know what happened between you two. I mean, he said that you were dating, but then I went to check on him. He was kind of a mess. Justin, a mess? Kaden, you know how when you start dating someone, you always look good, but then when you break, you look tragic? Like you haven't showered in weeks? You have stains on your clothes, and so on and so forth. Justin, yeah, I get you. Kaden, now I think the breakup is after math time 68. Justin, really? I was gonna call him. I've been meeting him. I really have. It's just I'm tired and hurting him, honestly. I fucked up. I always fuck up. Kaden, what happened? Are you cheating or something? Justin, or something? Justin, or something.
Jackson.
I didn't really want to discuss with them until I at least tell them. Kaden.
Stop uploading.
I'm not. Yeah, man, I totally understand. Is there anything I can do to help? Justin, actually, yeah, you can. You guys get to know the Noah's plan. You guys don't get to know the plan. Oh, great. With Austin. Alex. Alex, oh my god, Lex. Alex, what? You know you like this. Austin laughing. Alex, please stop. Alex, stop tickling him. Okay, okay, so what's up with you and Justin? Austin, nothing. Why? You want me back, huh? Alex, don't get so full of yourself. Austin face gasps. Oh my god, you want Justin instead of me? Alex, well, he is pretty hot. Have you seen his body? Austin, yeah, I get to look it.
No!
I get to look
seriously?
On it every day. Alex, you know you should lick on him right now. Austin grabs on Alex's crotch and pulls him through his basketball shorts. How about I do you one better and let you pound my ass into oblivion? Alex, that's a pretty great offer, but I'm gonna say ice cream. Austin, oh. Alex, so have you and Justin slept together since you got back? I haven't seen you this horny since I went out of town last year, for spring break last year. Austin, I'm not dating.
You don't
know
need
that.
A play-by-play.
Alex, that hasn't stopped you before. Austin, shut up. Let's go get some ice cream. Alex, alright, you're buying, right?
How many times have you seen
Austin, no. You're the guy in this relationship. Alex, how did that happen? Austin, you talked. Alex, seriously? Austin, you should have let me have control. Alex, oh, whatever. You like it when I stick my Austin ice cream. Alex laughed. So, I never got to ask about your bruises. What happened? Austin, nothing. Just some rough sex. Alex, well, I always knew you were a freak, but Justin might have really given it to you. Austin, I asked for it. Austin, Alex, and is this the reason why you haven't been on speaking terms? Alex, I never said we weren't talking. Alex, you didn't have to. Austin, are you just giving each other space? Alex, does space include never talking or seeing each other around the house? Austin, if he doesn't want to come out of his room, I'm not going to force him. Alex, it's New Year's Eve. Who are you going to kiss at midnight? Austin pulls Alex close to his neck. Who do you think? Alex gets closer enough that their lips are gazing. Austin, your pillow? Alex, fuck you! Leans up and kisses Alex. Alex pulls away. What happened to that ice cream? Austin, I don't think it's hot enough yet. Oh my god. Why don't you see if we can break a sweat? Alex, yeah, how about you stop being such a thought? Austin, you're just as much as a hoe as me, Mr. Cheater. Alex, whatever. Now let's go get some ice cream. Austin, but I want sex. Whines. Alex, shut up, now let's go. 10 p.m. with Justin. Kian, he's not coming, Justin. Justin, seriously? Kian, he won't even get out of his bed. Justin, I'm sorry, I tried, I really did. Justin, it's cool, man. Thanks, I'll see you in a few. Kaden, alright, bye, JB. Hangs up. Justin gets up. Gets in his car and drives off. 3 minutes later. Blank opens. It's close to it. Justin walks in. Happy New Year to you, too! Sits on his bed. So, the flowers are for you. Blank, I don't want them. Justin, I also miss you. Blank, you're a liar. I hate you. Justin, you know you never gave me a chance to explain. Blank, and I'm not gonna let you now. Justin, seriously? You're that upset with me? Blank, I'm upset with you because you lied to me, but I'm even more upset with myself because I knew you would do something, and I went with it. And I know that you're only here because you want something, and you probably got into a fight with your boyfriend. You know, it really kills me that you did all this right before Christmas. This time of year, when you're supposed to be with ones you care about, you left me. Justin, I've honestly never been hated so something or someone so much until I met you. But I love you so much, I hate these feelings that I have for you. Because honestly, they make no sense. Justin, you done? You done now? Blank, fuck you. Get out.
There's a death barrier.
Justin, I think that's one of the nicest things you've ever said to me. Blank, what, Justin? Justin, I want to spend New Year's with my baby. Blank, so where's Selena or Justin? I just want to be with you and no one else, okay? Blank, yeah, for this moment in time, you want me. But come tomorrow, you won't mean anything. I won't mean anything to you. I never do. Justin, that's not true. I really do love you. Blank, there it goes again. Justin, I'm not lying to you. I do love you. But I love him a little more. You know that. You also know I would never intentionally hurt you. Blank. So then where have you been, Justin? Because you clearly didn't love me enough to stay by my side. Justin, is this what you've been telling yourself, huh? I told you I wanted you. Is that so hard to believe? Blank. Yes, it is. Why? Because the time after you hurt me, I'm tired of it. And I'm gonna let you do this to me anymore? Damn it. Justin stays quiet and didn't say anything. Blank kisses Justin. I hate that I love you, baby. Justin, I love you. I'm sorry. I never meant to hurt you. Forgive me? Blank, no, I can't. If I did, I could never forgive myself. I'm sorry. Justin, don't be sorry. I'm gonna be faithful from this point on. I'm just gonna need your help. Can you do that for me? Blank nods their heads and hugs Justin. Justin hugs back tired. Thanks, babe. Kisses Blank. This is taking fucking forever. Sorry, school and prom and stuff is stressing me out. So basically, Justin and Blank bringing New Year's with ice cream and kissing all that stuff. Who do you think Blank is? Do you like it? Who do you guys think this mysterious person is? I have literally no freaking clue. I have a pretty good idea of who it might be. I have a feeling it's Vincent. I could be wrong. So let me not...